We all family here. One big family at Greyston. When somebody starts working here, I basically like show them the ropes. Most fun part is you can eat all the brownies you want.
So here at Greyston, we focus on your future. We focus to build your career here at Greyston. We focus for you to build your work, your future, and to build a community, to go back to your family and say, hey, I have this opportunity at Greyston. Open hiring gives an opportunity to an individual that's been through a journey of looking for that one opportunity, that one job, even with a background that's not designed to get a job. Here is a new world. It's taking an individual and just working with them from the beginning to the end and seeing that success that they came in with no experience, not knowing that they were going to get an opportunity, and nurture that opportunity to success. It's the trainings that we provide here within the soft skills and the trainings that we provide to help them understand the workplace, make them a successful employee.
The open hiring, I like that. You know, it gives a lot of people opportunity. It's hard to find jobs. Like, for me, it was hard for me to find a job. My first role, I was an apprentice for 6 months before I graduated to being the lead operator.
Hiring is a no questions asked hiring policy. That means we don't do background checks, resumes, drug tests. We don't do credit checks. We don't look for certain degrees. We ask people to sign up on our job list, and then we take the next person off of the list when we have jobs available. Open hiring is an opportunity, not a promise. So we're opening our doors to anyone who's interested in employment, but then we hold them accountable to certain standards, because we have to in order to run a profitable business. I mean, folks who don't meet the standards that we set are asked to leave, but those for whom they are ready and willing to work, we find tremendous talent in the pools of folks who come through our doors. People think that might mean that there's mayhem or chaos in our bakery, but it's really the opposite. We run a world-class manufacturing facility. We serve world-class clients in Unilever, Ben & Jerry's, and Whole Foods, and we practice a rigorous accountability model. Open hiring is an opportunity, not a promise, and so those for whom they're not ready to work, you know, we're not shy about holding them accountable to the standards that we've set. I would challenge companies to start somewhere. I think sometimes companies get wrapped up in, wow, open hiring is so different from what we do. Where do I even start? But you don't necessarily have to go full open hiring, but just start somewhere. Remove the background check, or maybe get rid of the interview, or maybe you don't really need to have a high school degree for that job. Think about small ways in which you can make changes to your organization and then see the impact that that can have. We really hope that companies will just take action, because this is an area where they really can have an immense impact relatively quickly.
What I like about my role and just Greyston in general is the opportunity to see transformation take place, and that transformation begins with just one job. And that's what we do at Greyston day in and day out. We get to see people's lives transformed. We literally change lives. For the groups that the folks that we serve here and the folks that we employ day in and day out, we're, in a non-judgment way, we're bringing in folks that may have be returning from being justice involved. They may be dealing with recovery. They may be homeless. They may be dealing with domestic violence issues. And we give them an opportunity to not just get employed, but we provide the support systems for them to stay employed so that they're not worried about childcare issues. They're not worried about child support issues. They're not worried about housing issues. And we provide those supportive services here so that they can both be productive on the job, but more importantly, be productive at home. You have to understand, and I think we do need to acknowledge the fact that this is a radically different way of hiring. So let's just acknowledge that. To an industry that's used to hiring in a certain way, they're doing the background checks, they're used to doing interviews, they're used to going through an application and reviewing someone's background. And now we're saying, forget all that. Bring in the next person on the job. When you look at some of the jobs that we have, whether it's manufacturing, a distribution center, what interview process do you really need to go through to hire that person? Are they willing to take instruction? Will they show up? Will they be on time? Do they want to be successful and take instructions from their supervisor? That's pretty much it. And as long as you're legally able to work in the U.S., that's all that should be required of anybody. And the training will happen as you do the job. It's actually a family in here. if I could say that, because the folks are just so happy to be employed by Greyston. They're so happy to be contributing and to actually produce a product, and a product for a world-class customer like a Ben & Jerry's, a Whole Foods, Sheets, Cava. These companies have high standards, and the folks that were once considered unemployable now are deemed essential. And P.S., they're also making a great product for world-class customers. So we're very proud of that.
I think one of the biggest surprises is just this fear of the unknown can be a really powerful force preventing companies from innovating and enacting change, right? I mean, we talk to lots of folks who think what we do is great, and yet when it comes to their own companies, they say, oh, well, that wouldn't work for us. But why not? We have great employees that come through open hiring, and every company should want to hire the people that we hire this way. Companies spend so much money screening people out, even for entry-level frontline jobs, thousands of dollars per employee sometimes, whether it's on background checks, the time that it takes to interview folks, and yet still companies that rely very heavily on entry-level talent oftentimes face extremely high rates of turnover. 50, 60, sometimes over 100% turnover in certain industries. And so are those practices that are so resource intensive really serving their intended purpose? We think that those resources are better spent investing in the folks who are interested in employment. So we spend essentially nothing on hiring and instead invest those resources helping our employees onboarding, training them, giving them access to wraparound supportive services that can help them solve some of the other issues in their lives that may prevent them from being successful at work. That use of resources has a much better ROI.
We want to make sure that we share this great open hiring model. We need more companies to join us in giving opportunities and focusing on the future and not the past.
Part of the challenge to the business community as we address this issue of access to employment is they don't really have to think long and hard about how they can make an impact now. The one lever that they do control is employment. And they can do that right now by changing their hiring practices, rethinking interviews, rethinking applications, rethinking background checks. That's something that the CEO could say right at this moment. And that could be a very impactful change. So that's my challenge to them.